Hey, what's up everyone, and once again welcome back to Super Smash Bros. Ultimate Classic Mode. Last time we took on Classic using Luigi and got a 9.2, and this time we're going to be heading through as Ness on Home to Onette. Let's do this. Starting off with his palettes, we of course have the regular Ness, this white one that I believe has been around since like Melee, maybe. Bumblebee Ness, green hat, blue hat, Mr. Satin shirt, a gooey man, and the checkerboard pattern, which I believe is based on like the loading screen or save screen from Earthbound or something like that. I'm not 100% sure on that, but let's jump on in with Ness. Now, let's see, can we see Ness on here? I feel like he'll probably be kind of early. Oh, Ness and Lucas, they're right there in the middle at the bottom. That is cute. Oh, and Mr. Satin's there as well. Okay, so why do the Mii Fighters and Mr. Satin get to be featured on this? But not Piranha Plant. Unless he is here and I just cannot see him. But I am fairly certain Piranha Plant is not on this mural. Also, I like that they put female Corrin on here. I'm fairly certain male Corrin is not on here. Ness versus Ness, okay, on Magikant. Starting off though, move list. PK Flash, PK Fire, PK Thunder, and PSI Magnet with PK Starstorm as the final smash. And the taunts, up taunts is the okay. We got the bat for the side taunt and this little light show for the down taunt. I guess I'm gonna start doing that with every fight, is I'm gonna do the, or every character, I'm gonna try to show off the move set or the move list right away, and then go right into the taunts before the enemy has a chance to get to us. We got kind of lucky with Ness because he's got some pretty fast taunts. Help me out, Flying Man. Thank you, friend. But yeah, I'll try to do that with the other characters too. I'm gonna roll over here. Okay, that didn't work. Flying Man, thank you. And new up air. Yeah. That's one of the main things they changed about Ness this time, I believe, is his up air. It's not just a headbutt anymore. Yeah, look, there's female Corrin. I don't see male Corrin. So even though male Corrin is like the default, I'm fairly certain they just realized, oh god, female Corrin's the more popular one. Put her on the mural! Okay, Lucas, that's just rude, bud. You know, we helped you out in subspace, and you're just gonna hit me with a stick. Well, I'm gonna pick this up and heal myself. Bye! Goodbye, and I'm throwing it over there, so you don't get it. PK Fire? How about PK Fire? How about some PK Fire? How about I grab you and I back throw you? Uh-huh, get up. Ugh. I'll take this assist trophy, too. Ooh, Knuckle Joe? I don't think you can survive Knuckle Joe there, Lucas. Well, if you actually let him get anywhere near you, which I don't think you're... Did he just fall? Okay, he's back. He parried Knuckle Joe. Okay, I should stop talking smack on Lucas over here. I feel he knows more than he lets on. Oh, you're dead, kid. You're dead, kid. That Chimera's gonna appear any second. Okay, you need to stop. There he is. Okay, that works. I was kinda hoping that would throw him to the Chimera, but... Nope. Did he have the rocket belt that I dropped? I think he did, because I think I just saw it, like, floating up. Still no female... Oh, no male Corrin. It's weird, because isn't female Robin also the most popular of the two Robin? So... That's kind of strange. Okay, we got three Robs. Interesting. All the same palette as well. Now, I'm not an Earthbound guy, so I really don't understand any of these references. Like, why did we fight another Ness at the beginning? If anybody knows, please let me know. Oh my god. Please let me know. Obviously, fighting Lucas makes sense, because Lucas. Lucas is the only other Earthbound fighter, so that makes sense. And we've only been on Earthbound stages so far as well. Haven't we? What was the first stage we were on? I'm losing my mind. Hello, Sheik. What the heck? Okay, now we're not on an Earthbound stage. We were on Magikant, then we were on New Pork City, and then Foresight. Okay, yeah, that's like the three Earthbound stages, I think. Oh, and there's Onette as well, which I guess will probably be the last one. Also, hi, Mr. Satin. That was a surprisingly easy fight, too. Give me that 0.9. Two Dark Toon Links. All right. We fought some Dark Toon Links with Luigi in the previous run, and now my dog is howling. And given that I'm the only one home, there's nobody downstairs to stop her from howling. So if you can hear her on the video, I apologize. She's loud. She's probably barking at the neighbors again because she does that. Or nothing. Or actually, yesterday I read a post on either Facebook or Twitter. You guys know the silence from Doctor Who? Probably not. Some of you might. Basically, when you look at them, you forget that you've seen them. So, there's a theory that the reason your dog barks at things at seemingly nothing is because it was actually the silence. And that's what they're barking at. But they didn't stop looking yet, so they didn't forget they were there. And then when they do look away and they stop barking, it's because they don't see him anymore and they forgot they were even there. Ooh, theories. Get out of here, Dark Toon Link. I will break this house. Stop that. Take it back. Oh yeah, Luke, Nessa's bat reflects projectiles, by the way. Kind of a defining trait of the boy. Okay, I want to stay, like, in the lower portion of the mansion because we're on really high damage right now. And at least if we get launched down here, we've got more of a chance to not get fully launched, I guess. I will just stand here and PK don't parry that! No, just let me get a grab. All I need is a grab. Stop that. Fine, I'm gonna go grab this assist trophy instead. That counts as a grab. It's the same guy again! You the only assist trophy, Jeff? The nobody else who can help me out? This Starman, he's an assist trophy, he's from Earthbound. I think they might give me a different one other than Jeff. Let me get a grab, that's all I want. Just one grab. It's all I need. PK Fire to grab will work, but you just have to actually connect with the PK Fire first. Which he's not letting me do. Okay. No! Okay, back throw, go! Yeah. We were at 200 damage. That's not gonna be the nicest play. Are you serious? I was joking, I didn't think it'd give us 0.1. Whatever. Whatever. What are you two doing in my house? Oh, on my house? I don't know which of these houses is Ness's, if any of them. Okay, that's actually bothering me. That is bothering me immensely. 0.1? That wasn't the worst play in the world. We still won. And we managed to survive at 200 damage. You think it'd give us more than 0.1? Or is it because I spammed PK Fire towards the end? Goodbye. You know, that's probably what it is. It's probably like, you did side B just a few too many times. And then it gives us a 0.9 for that one. Alright. Okay. I feel like the boss is gonna be the hands again. Like, I can't really think of any logical boss fight for this, because there's no Porky. They really should have brought Porky back, but they didn't, for whatever reason. I feel like porting him over from Brawl wouldn't have been the most arduous task to fulfill. I feel like any of the subspace bosses outside of Galleon would have been pretty easy to bring over. Well, not even outside of Galleon, because they brought him over. I just mean, like, if they were to do more subspace bosses, I feel like it wouldn't be the most difficult thing in the world to bring other ones in. Especially Porky. Like, yeah, forget about Duon, forget about Taboo, forget about any of the original bosses, but, like, Rayquaza, so that we had someone for the Pokemon fights, or, you know, like I said, Porky for the Earthbound characters, or... Okay, here we go. I guess we're not getting those, but whatever. Who else is in subspace as a boss? Petey Piranha, he's a boss. I guess he's in Piranha Plant's Final Smash, but still. The hands? It is indeed the hands. Alright, so we've basically got a guaranteed death here. Meaning we're probably not gonna hit even 9.0 with Ness. But I mean, it's kind of what I expected. We've done a little better than I was expecting to with Ness, to be honest with you. Because Ness is not one of my go-tos, neither is Lucas. I've just never been a huge fan of their playstyles. It's kind of weird because, you know, Ness has been around since the first game. You'd think I would have gotten used to him by now. I still haven't gotten used to that freaking attack, even though I try to avoid it every time. I just fail. Alright, if we can keep hitting them both. Okay, Crazy Hand. Yes, they're both down. Okay. Now, is that actually hitting both? Oh, it is. Ugh. See, look at that. We just did the same attack. But it did way less. There's no way stale moves causes that much of an effect. Like, I believe stale moves is a thing, but it doesn't do that much. Surely. You're gonna poke me? He's about to poke me. Okay, Master Hand's gonna be gone. Yes! Okay, and I think we hit Crazy too. Oh my god, are we gonna do it? Oh, okay. Alright. Screw what I said about a guaranteed death. I was honestly not expecting to pull that off, but I am not complaining. Not complaining at all. What is that gonna pump us up to? Oh my god! Whoa. We got 9.9 with Ness! What? It gave us a 1.1? I don't think we've ever gotten a 1.1. Dudes, we got a 9.9 after getting 0.1 in one of these matches. That is ridiculous. That was honestly kind of a weak run, I'm not gonna lie. Not the actual classic run, just the credits game. It felt like I got hit by a lot of things. So, either way, you know, got a decent amount of points, and also got all 4 or 5 or whatever of the prizes, so I'm not gonna complain.
Final results.
Shaman Landform. We got Fantoon, it's disgusting. And Elecman. Alrighty. And less gold, because I guess because we got 9.9, it's like, we're gonna give you a spirit instead. I'm not complaining though. My goddamn, 9.9 with Ness, that is not what I expected. Also, one very minor thing that I think would have been kinda neat is, you know how we get these little medals on the character when you've beaten their classic route? What if you have completed it on 9.9, you got like a different colored one? I mean, that would annoy some people who don't want to go for the 9.9s, but people like me, it would be so satisfying if we could get the 9.9 and the metal was like a different color. Maybe that's just me, I don't know, but anyways. With that, folks, that's going to go ahead and do it for this episode of Super Smash Bros. Ultimate Classic Mode. Next time we'll be playing through as Captain Falcon. So, if you guys enjoyed this video, please make sure to leave a like, and of course let me know what you thought of it in the comment section below. Stay tuned for the next one, and I'll see you guys then.